Hey, Coach. On Tuesday is going to be the, I guess, the anniversary, 1 year anniversary of Kobe Bryant's passing, along with Gigi. I just wanted to know your thoughts about, like, one of your greatest memories with him, against him, or yeah, against him as a coach.
Well, I've got one great memory and a lot of bad memories. I mean, you know, when you competed against him, you were always competing against the very best, who was always pushing it to get it to an even higher level. So, you know, Kobe Bryant was, you know, he and Jordan, you know, were two guys that were at the very top in terms of, you know, pushing the game competitively. He was a tireless worker, and so he was always great at the end of games because he always practiced and simulated all that stuff. You know, there were a lot of nights he hit big shots against my teams. You know, the good memory that I had was, you know, in 2011 when we beat those guys. But as I mentioned last year around this time, it was, you know, it was the day after his passing. My warm memories are just him as the respectful competitor. You know, he was a guy that anytime I ran into him in a hallway or something, he would give a warm handshake and coach, how you doing, stuff like that. But, you know, in the back of that eyeball, you knew there was a killer who was waiting to go at you next time, you know. So I knew this was coming because on my phone and all my internet stuff, I'm seeing Kobe Bryant commemorative, you know, jackets, shirts, and all those kinds of things. And, you know, it'll be a gut-wrenching day. I remember it so very well. This is one of those moments in history. You know exactly where you were when you heard.
Tim Cato, go ahead.
Hey, KP played in the back-to-back last weekend. You've got another back-to-back coming up. I know it's a collaborative effort to determine, you know, if he can play multiple games in a row in that type of situation. But as a coach, what are you looking for to, you know, signs that maybe he should sit out or signs that, you know, his minutes are going too high or something like that? What are you looking for in that area?
Yeah, I'm not going to talk about, you know, whether he's going to play both games or anything like that. I mean, you know, we're really focused on the game tomorrow. Look, these are two tough divisional games and very important ones. And the West is going to be so challenging all year long. You can see how congested it is, you know, in spots, you know, 4 through 10, you know, it's just real crowded. KP's doing well. You know, we're watching his situation. We will watch it very, very closely. And, you know, we'll make the decision, you know, as we feel is appropriate. But there's no decision that's been made at this point.
Brad Townsend?
You mentioned a divisional game, and I get this question from fans a lot. What do divisions mean at this point?
Well, there is meaning to having the best record in your division and having a good divisional record because it's criteria for tiebreakers and stuff like that. And so, you know, they made sure as things have been restructured, realigned over the past several years that the divisional games, you know, still had an extra meaning aspect to it. So, yeah, and when you look at the standings right now in the West and how tight it is from top to bottom, you know, tiebreakers are going to be extremely important, you know, come playoff time and come, you know, when teams are getting ready for the play-in games and all that kind of stuff.
Okay, next we'll go to Jordan Richard.
Hey, Rick. You put Josh Green in the starting lineup last game. You know, he did a great job, you know, diving to the rim, you know, when KP caught the ball, you know, in the paint, you know, just diving. It just made some good high energy plays and did some good things defensively. Can you just talk about, you know, just how he impacted the game yesterday and started for you guys yesterday?
Yeah, he's had a few starts, and or at least a couple. And look, he's a terrific competitor. He has a very good skill level. The thing I love about him, he's going to give you tireless, boundless energy no matter what. And, you know, if there's a loose ball, you know, he's either going to have it or he's going to be right in there getting his hands on it. And, you know, I just feel like, you know, he's a guy that, you know, is going to get better and better as he plays more. Doesn't mean he's going to start every game or anything like that, but this is an opportunity for him to play meaningful minutes. You know, and the situation in Indy was unique. You know, Turner was out, and so they were going with a very small lineup, and so it made sense to size down. And, you know, he was the guy that that we decided on. And, you know, it was great to see him do a good job. I mean, it's the more reinforcement you can get and the more opportunity to play you can get as a young player, you know, it's it breeds a lot of confidence and a lot of, you know, a lot of belief in what you're doing.
Last one from Eddie Sefko.
Yeah, along those lines, Rick, how much has Josh had to be kind of fast-tracked on everything? And has he had to do, just because of all the absentees, way more than maybe he or you expected him to have to do?
Are you in a swimming pool or something? Jesus, you got the Blue Angels flying overhead. What's happening there?
I've got the Indy 500 running outside my door.
Yeah. Is Emerson Fittipaldi winning? Yeah. Look, the whole thing for these guys has been an amazing fast track. Hell, they got drafted less than 2 months ago, I think. And, you know, now this guy's starting in an NBA game, started in an NBA game last night. You know, Tyrell Terry's been tossed into some games, you know, probably, you know, unexpectedly in his mind. But, you know, we believe in these guys. And, you know, the only way you can find out what they're capable of is to give them a shot to play. So, look, this has been an incomparable, you know, set of circumstances for rookies this year, you know, having to be tossed into this thing. Really, I mean, you're in training camp almost, you know, less than 2 weeks from when you were drafted. It's nuts. But these kids have all adjusted well. I mean, I'm watching all the rookies around the league, you know, top to bottom. You know, they've handled it, and they've handled it in a very big way.